Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, a station where you watch and learn. I'm your tutor, Phyllaris Tirit. I'm going to take you through English Form 1. And today we're going to look at English Form 1, Lesson 20. Our topic will be on listening and speaking. The subtopic will be focused on oral literature. And so, I expect you as a learner by the end of the lesson to be able to define what is literature, name reasons for studying oral literature, and functions of oral literature in our societies. We'll begin our lesson by defining what an oral literature is, and we'll say an oral literature is a performed art which uses words as a medium of communication. Performance is a very important aspect of oral literature because in every presentation, it becomes totally a new rendition, even if presented by the same person. So we've said an oral literature is a performed art which uses words as a medium of communication. We have the common and verbal cues in oral literature, the common non-verbal cues. These are the cues that we cannot speak, that they can be dramatized by our body. This includes facial expression, tone variation, gestures, dramatization, body movements, and mimicry. We can look at the next question, which is, why do we study oral literature? As a learner, as a student, why do we study oral literature? Oral literature is class studied for many reasons, which include national integration. Through oral literature, we are able to live together in peace and harmony as people of one nation because we become enlightened about our shared common marriage. For instance, when we talk of national integration, this means we live in peace and community with one another because, for instance, in Kenya, we have different groups from different tribes. And at the end of the day, these tribes end up interacting with one another, leading to marriages, warfares, and such. Through that interaction, it leads to national integration as a country. We can also say oral literature is studied for reasons such as socialization. Oral literature is a social process that always involves more than one person to complete. This means when we study oral literature, we tend to socialize or know more about other cultures. And we also have preservation of cultures. It is crucial to preserve our culture richly couched in oral literature. Oral literature borrows from society, and our traditional society is quickly changing due to globalization. When we look at communities in Kenya, we tend to see that most of the communities have their cultures, but due to globalization, most of the cultures are being done away with. And so if we study oral literature, it tends to remind us of our cultures or who are we as Africans. Another point, study oral literature for education and transmission of values. Oral literature is a major tool of education. It extols virtue and mocks or punishes vices in society. Through different stories or arts in society, we tend to see that oral literature is a tool of education. It impacts good morals. It mocks or punishes the bad vices in the society, such as greediness, jealousy, and such. Another reason as to why we study oral literature is because of cultural understanding and acceptance. Through oral literature, we learn about the cultural practices of different communities. This knowledge makes us more tolerant of other people's practices. For instance, in Kenya, we have different tribes with different cultures. And so at the end of the day, these people tend to interact. And when you interact, you tend to learn about other cultures and respect people for who they are because of their cultures and the communities where they come from. So oral literature has been classified into the following genres. We have the oral narratives, we have the songs, oral poetry, we have the riddles, we have the proverbs and wise sayings, we have the tongue twisters, we have jokes and puns. So our assignment today, we're going to define, you as a learner, I expect you to be able to define what is literature, identify functions of literature in our societies. For much more on these, you can refer them to Excelling in English, Students Book 1, 3rd edition, which is published by the Kenya Literature Bureau. You can also reach us on the following, our SMS line is posted there, on YouTube, Elimu TV, Facebook, Elimu TV, Twitter, @ Elimu TV_KE. Thank you for the lesson.